Every single death was avoidable. That's the damning verdict of a report into Britain's Grenfell Tower disaster. 72 people were killed when a massive fire, fuelled by combustible cladding, tore through the social housing block.
It is still standing at 24 stories tall. Grenfell Tower is a monument to tragedy and a symbol of systemic failures.
Human life was never a priority, and we lost friends, neighbours and loved ones in the most horrific way.
June 14, 2017. What started as a small fire in one apartment spread rapidly, fuelled by combustible cladding, which was added in a refurbishment only a year before. 72 people were killed, among them taxi drivers, architects, a poet, an acclaimed young artist, and 18 children.
The simple truth is that the deaths that occurred were all avoidable, and those who lived in the tower were badly failed over a number of years and in a number of different ways.
According to the report, governments were warned of the dangers but failed to act. The cladding manufacturers engaged in systematic dishonesty about the product's fire risk, while the council and landlords showed a persistent indifference to fire safety. Some residents in the social housing block, which is in London's richest neighbourhood, had raised concerns before the blaze, but they were dismissed as troublemakers.
Because this tragedy poses fundamental questions about the kind of country we are, a country where the voices of working class people and those of colour have been repeatedly ignored and dismissed.
More than 4,000 residential buildings across the UK are still covered in dangerous cladding. Work is underway to remove the unsafe material, but even the government admits it is taking too long.
Any kind of justice is also years away. It's now up to police to decide if charges are laid. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, London.